Hello my brothers and sisters, welcome you to my name is Beautiful G, and I'm finally back doing videos. Now I'm full vacation, so I wanted to do another video since I'm, as I said, in vacation. So this new video is about my country, Portugal. And I wanted to do this video since Portugal nowadays is a hot spot for tourists, a marvel of touristic attractions, and elected by many years, I think Lisbon is now the second year in a row the best elected by tourists, the best European city, 2 years in a row, I think. Is that or Oporto? I don't know, but Portuguese, so woohoo! Now, I wanted to do this video as the main reason why you should come to Portugal. Not the touristic attractions, not the food, the babies is one reason. Not the beaches, not the historic, not the wine, not the nature. I wanted to do the top reasons why you should come to Portugal. The real top reasons why you should. So, enjoy! Reason number one? Guess what? We are not such a PC fucking cunts like in America and Canada. Oh, Jesus Christ, Canada, what have you become? Now, sure, you can say, oh, but there are some politically correct people in your country. Yes, there are, but not in such a vocal way there is and exists in Canada and in America specifically, because we see nowadays that Canada put out that law with pronouns and, Jesus, it just makes my head hurt just thinking about that shit. So, we're not a PC country, so that's reason number one. Fui criado como um bezerro rejeitado, mamei em vacas em... Reason number two, we're not easily offended. Okay, there's some things the Portuguese people get triggered by, but there are specifically, I think, three or four things that we specifically get triggered by. First is, we're not a province of Spain. If somebody says to us, oh, you're a province of Spain, you'll look in the eyes and with a stare, we're not saying fuck you, but we'll glance at you with our eyes, and our eyes will tell you to go fuck yourself. The second topic is, we don't speak Spanish, we speak Portuguese. This is both a thing we and the Brazilian people find offensive. You don't check out the Brazilians, other video the Brazilians did on that topic, and they find it offensive. They don't speak Spanish, they don't speak Brazilian, they speak Portuguese. They said it themselves, I'm not speaking for them. One of them said it, okay? I'm not representing the Brazilians, okay? Gotcha. Another topic is, if somebody says, Portuguese, says that the 25th of April was a mistake, everyone hates that person or lost a big amount of respect towards that person. So, what I mean by this, so, for those who don't know, the 25th of April was the revolution, the coup de grace, when the military, the Portuguese military, overthrew the regime, the dictator regime, as known in Portugal, o Estado Novo, and since 1974, we live in a democracy. So if anybody says it was a mistake, we define it very extremely offensive. So we don't have an extreme right represented on the Republic Assembly, so no worries about that. Tudo que tinha feito crescia assim desse jeito, fiquei mal habituado. Now, the top third reason why you should come to Portugal, again, with the PC thing, we are not as risky as Americans, specifically when it comes to other races or representing another culture. Specifically to us, here's the thing. There was a movie, Silence, and the actors on the story, if you don't know, Silence is a movie last year or the beginning of this year by Martin Scorsese, and about two Portuguese Jesuit priests. Now, the actors and the priests were not Portuguese, the three main priests. One was British, I think the other was, Liam Neeson was Irish, I don't think. But they're not Portuguese, okay? They're not Portuguese. But here's the thing, we don't give a shit. We do not give a flying fuck. Even, for the sake of the argument, when I saw the movie, I went with my parents, and I asked my father about that, if he felt offended that the Portuguese priests were not the Portuguese priests' characters were not played by Portuguese actors. And he said to me simply, it's an American film, what kind of question is that, basically? And I just asked him that because of BuzzFeed and all that PC culture bullshit. Another thing I want to, in this reason why you should come to Portugal, is we make fun a lot of the whitewashing and the PC culture, again, of America and Canada. More of America, because America is just, they are all fucked up in the head, if you think about it for 5 seconds. Eu gosto de mamar nos peitos da cabritinha. Eu gosto de mamar. Reason number 5 is, if we're not a PC country, and here's why, we have bullfighting. Yes, we have bullfighting. The thing that most countries and most people just get triggered by. If anyone says they like it, you're basically a fucking Nazi. But this thing, I personally enjoy bullfighting. The Portuguese style, not the Spanish style of bullfighting. But this thing, you can have a normal conversation with the people that disagree with you. Not in America or Canada, they seem to just shout, "Oh, you're Nazi! Well, you're a fucking SJP, that you can't!" There's all the conversation between my generations in America and Canada. It seems that way, and probably is all that. But yeah, there's another point there that I mentioned. You can have about normal conversations about controversial topics or controversial opinions. In my college, I have known a person who has extreme right ideas, and you know, I personally identify my political ideology as more left leaning, not in the Democrats, American Canadian way, more in the, well, Portuguese way of things, but I don't identify with any Portuguese party, so I'm kind of a neutral left, if that's possible description. But what I mean by this, you can have a normal conversation, and I had a normal conversation with him and another girl who had, let's just say, I don't think is a majority opinion when it comes to Muslims. I had a conversation with her when it comes to how to deal with Islam and the Muslims and the Sharia law. You know, it was a very constructive talk, you know. It's that thing, in here, in the universities and the college, your ideals are challenged, not confirmed, okay? There's a big difference in college, I think, here, and overseas on the other side of the pond, because what I'm reading is, in America, the college or universities, you go there just to get your views confirmed or established even more. That's why people watch Fox News or CNN, just to re-establish their views and points, not to get them challenged, you know. There's a YouTuber, Boogie298, if you don't know who he is, you should definitely subscribe to him. And he speak about Lizzie Green. I was a feminist and all that, but he says he likes to talk to her because it challenges, she challenges his ideals, and it makes him, you know, battle out if he's right and considering it philosophically, if he's right or wrong, you know. That's one of the reasons why, if there's people watching overseas, and I watch, or my analytics more most of the people who watch my videos are from America and the United Kingdom. So if you're thinking about selling it here, you can, and your reviews will be challenged. Universities in Portugal, at least my university in Braga, are not a safe space. So do not worry about that.
Hoje sou homem, arranjei uma cabritinha e passo o dia a mamar nos peitinhos da fofinha.
Top 6th reason why you should come to Portugal. Now, this one is really interesting because this reason is for the YouTubers, the Prank Invasion, the Soflo, the Vitaly, the Cock TV, you know what I mean, the Cock TV. If you're watching this, by a long shot of probably any who I mentioned right now, watch this video, which probably 1 in 100 million possibility. But you come here, you have babes, hot babes. As one of the things, you should definitely come to Portugal. We have one of the finest women in Europe. We have the finest women in Europe. And yes, I know this is Slovenia. I went there. The women are gorgeous in Slovenia. Lithuania has beautiful women as well. French, okay. Italian, But you come here, and especially Lisbon, Porto and Algarve. Oh boy! You come here, Prank Invasion, Vitaly, Soflo, you have all the juicy material. You have bomb-ass girls, you have all the... Oh, another real reason why you should come to Portugal, Americans, if you're watching this, legally you can drink when you are 18 years old, so you don't have to wait until they're 21 to drink. So there's another reason why you should come to Portugal. But what I mean by this, if Prank Invasion Vitaly, you want to come here, want to make social experiments, if you want to make kissing videos, you have the right material, you have the right girls, and if you want, the summer is the best time to do it. Why? Because there are only not Portuguese, there are tourists as well, there are British, Germans, Dutch, Spanish, Italians, so every flavor of Europe can show comes to Lisbon to spend vacation. Or Lisbon and Algarve specifically is more and more on Oporto, but more on those cities, on those regions, Lisbon and Algarve specifically. So you have the juicy gist to make pranks on the hood, gone wrong, gone wild, gone sexual! Ding dong grabbing boobs on the beach 2017 Portuguese style bitch! So there you go guys, I think that's really the top reasons why you should come to Portugal. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please leave a like and subscribe. And if you didn't, dislike this video and tell me why so I can improve with my videos going forward. So, as always my brothers and sisters, I will see you around and I'll see you next time.